Buzzer TV presents vintage game shows on Amazon.
Shuffle, cut, deal, and play. Someone is going to win today on Card Sharks. And here's the host of Card Sharks, Jim Perry.
Thank you. Thank you very much. I thank you. Welcome to Card Sharks. See that? Yesterday we invited some people to send in poems. Your poems get better under pressure, Gene. Nice to have you here with us. We've got a game in progress, and I do hope you'll make decisions along with our players as we get to the cards. Janice and Ann, load in the cards, please, if you will, while we meet today's Card Sharks. Sheila Lyons, our champion. Hi, Sheila.
Hi, Jim.
Good to see you again.
Thank you.
And again, a reminder, you are from San Clemente, California,
yes.
And you've won how much money so far?
$6,500.
$6,500 in cold cash. Yeah. That's not bad, huh? You think you'd win that much when you came down?
No. In fact, I really doubted that I would even get on.
Now, you're doing very well. And our challenger, this is Sandy Miller. Hi, Sandy. Nice to see you again. And we just met you yesterday, so why don't you tell us a little bit about yourself?
Okay. I'm from a very small town in Kentucky called Paraville. We have 3,000 people.
What place?
Paraville.
Paraville, Kentucky.
Mm-hmm.
You know all the people in Paraville?
I sure do. And
everybody.
I think they're all watching, so hi, everybody from Card Sharks.
Well, that's terrific. We got 3,000 viewers in Paraville, Kentucky.
Right.
That's
sure
a way to do it. Good luck in the match to each of you. Each player has her own deck of 52 playing cards. Shuffled and cut before we go in the air. And the upper cards, the red cards, will be played by the champion, Sheila. The lower cards, the blue cards, will be played by the challenger, Sandy. And as we left off with the game in progress, Sheila needs just one card. Sandy needs four. That's the object of the game, to work your way across the board, predicting whether each card is higher or lower than the one that precedes it. Before you can begin calling high-low in the cards, you must win a high-low toss-up question based on a poll of 100 people. We play the best two out of three. And we're in the middle of game number one. Sheila, as we left off, the next question goes to you. We asked 100 married women, if there were a pill that would double your sex drive, would you take it? How many married women said they would take it?
Oh, that is really tough. If they have to take it and it's forced by their husband, I would imagine quite a few. I'm going to kind of stick to the middle and go about 47.
47. A lot of men in the audience were shouting out 110 or 120. You don't understand. We pull 100, you see. She says 47. Sandy, higher or lower?
Well, I think they all enjoy it, so I'm going to say higher.
You say higher. The actual number of married women who would take a pill that would double their sex drive or cut their headaches is 48. It's higher. Sandy, yes. By one. Sandy, we're looking at a queen as your base card. Now, you won the question. You have the right to change that if you'd like. Do you want to play it or change it?
I'm going to keep it and go lower.
Lower than a queen. It is an ace. Right up the middle. Remember, you can freeze at any time.
I'm going to go ahead and play it. And I think it's higher.
You say higher. Higher than an eight, taking a risk. Remember, if you're wrong, you're going to give Sheila a chance to play for free, and she needs only one card. Higher? Yes, an ace! You took a chance and it paid off, Sandy.
I'm going to go ahead and play it for lower.
Continuing on, risking those cards in this one. Lower than an ace, it is. It's a 10. Now she'll freeze. We move the freeze bar over, and that means that Sandy needs just one card. Sheila needs one. We're at sudden death. Someone has to win with the next play of the cards. This will decide it. Sandy, we asked 100 people, have you ever hit someone in the face with a pie? How many people said they had?
100! Oh, I don't believe that many people have hit that many people with pies. I'm going to say 19.
19 people have hit someone in the face with a pie. Sheila, higher or lower?
I have to agree with her. I don't think that many have. I think it's going to be a little bit lower.
You say lower than 19.
Yeah.
This will decide that all-important control. The actual number of people who said they have hit someone in the face with a pie is 16. Okay. It's lower. Sheila.
Oh, now I got
Sheila, now not sudden death. Remember, you have a 10. You have the right to change it if you'd like and try to turn this one card over. If you're wrong, Sandy wins. Or you can force Sandy to play off this 10, which she cannot change. And if she's wrong with this one card, you win. It's your decision. Do you want to play it for one card or force Sandy to play it for one?
Really a tough decision. I think I'm going to play it myself.
You're going to try it. You want to play it with a 10 or you want to change that card?
My cards haven't been too lucky. I'm going to play the 10, and I'm going to call it lower.
If this is lower than a 10, Sheila wins the first game of the match. If not, Sandy wins it. For the win... Challenger has to make a comeback, which will be coming up right after we take time out for this commercial message. We'll clear the board. All right, Sheila, you've got the first game, and $100 will deal out the cards with the same two decks of cards. Sandy, you need this to tie, and the question to you, Sheila. We asked 100 married men, after you became engaged, did you have one last fling before the wedding? How many men admitted they did have one last fling?
There's so many bachelor parties and everything, and you might consider that a fling. How many said they did? I'm going to say 62.
62. Sheila, do you think that your husband had one last fling?
I know he did.
Sandy, she says 62 out of 100 said, yeah, after they became engaged, they had one last fling. What do you think, higher
no,
or lower?
No, I don't think it's that high. I'm going to go lower.
You say lower.
Yeah.
The actual number of married men who admitted they had one last fling before the wedding is 21. Yeah. Very much lower, Sandy. All right, Sandy, you're starting off with a 3.
I'm going to keep it, and I'm going to say higher.
Higher than a 3. A jack, very much higher.
Freeze.
You'll freeze on the jack. All right, we'll move the freeze bar over. That surprised me that you'd freeze on that jack, Sandy.
I don't want to lose it.
You don't want to lose it. You want to hang on to that.
Yeah.
And the question to you, Sandy. We asked 100 married women. Remember the last question? After you became engaged, did you have one last fling before the wedding? How many women admitted, yeah, they had one last fling?
Oh, I don't think women have. No, I'm going to say, let's see. 21.
21. That's what the men was, 21. You say 21. Sheila, higher or lower?
I don't think women do. Once they've made the decision, that's it. I'm going to say lower.
You say lower. Sheila, you said your husband...
No.
Okay. Don't have to ask the question, huh? The actual number of married women who admitted they did have one last fling before the wedding is... 18. Oh, it's lower. Yeah.
Give me a good one.
Isn't it awful that those women would do a thing like that? Sheila, your base card is a king.
All right. I'll call the next card lower.
Lower than a king. It is an 8.
I'm going to freeze.
And you'll freeze. We've got a tie. Both players needing 3 cards to win. Sheila, we polled 100 women executives across the country. Now, these women are all vice presidents of corporations. We asked them, if someone told you that you think just like a man, would you be flattered? How many women executives said yes, they would be flattered?
I don't think too many would. They want credit all their own. I'm going to say 15.
15 women executives, all vice presidents, said yes, they'd be flattered if they thought like a man, or people thought they thought like a man, Sandy.
Well, I think men think pretty good, so I'm going to say higher.
You say higher?
Yeah.
Oh, you think they'd like to emulate the men?
That wouldn't be too bad.
The actual number of women executives who said they would be flattered if someone told them they think just like a man is 36. Yes! Sandy, very much higher. Sandy, you wanted to hang on to the jack. Do you want to play it?
I'm going to hang on to it and go lower.
Lower than a jack.
Yes!
It's a 6.
I'm going to go higher.
Continuing risking that card and this one higher. No, it's a 5. It's not higher. You lose both of those cards. Back to the jack. Sheila, you can't change the 8. Call this one.
I'm going to call it lower.
Lower than an 8. Oh, no, it's another 8. It is not lower, and you lose that card. We'll fill in the spaces, and again, we're at a sudden death situation. And, Sandy, we asked 100 housewives across the country. Have you ever refused to answer the phone because your favorite soap opera was on? How many housewives said, yeah, they refused to answer the phone?
That's really hard, because they're both pretty interesting. I'm kind of always nosy about who's calling, though. So I'm going to say 40.
40. She says 40 out of 100 have refused to answer the phone when the favorite soap opera is on, Sheila.
I do it, and I'm going to go with my own intuition and say it's higher.
Higher than that? That rather surprises me, and I don't know the answer. I'll find out as you do the actual number of housewives, besides my wife, who said they refused to answer the phone because their favorite soap opera was on, is 12. It's not higher. Sandy. All right, Sandy, now you've got a jack. You can try to turn these three cards over, or you can force Sheila to play off the eight and try these three. Your decision, play or pass?
I'm gonna give it to her. She does it.
All yours, Sheila. Sheila, if you can turn these three cards over, you remain the champion. If not, we've got a tie match. Call this.
I'm gonna call it higher.
Higher than an eight? No, it's not higher, and Sandy ties up the match. Tiebreaker, ladies. Good strategy there, Sandy. Each player with $100 in one game. Someone's going to get a crack at the money cards where they can win thousands. As with the tiebreaker, we have just three cards up there and three questions. Control, very important. Sheila, we asked 100 mothers whose sons are married. Have you ever told your daughter-in-law things you would not want your son to know? How many mothers said they had? Tricky question.
I don't think too many would, but I'm gonna go with about 42.
42, she says 42 out of 100 mothers have told their daughter-in-law things they wouldn't want the son to know, Sandy.
I don't have any idea. I'm gonna just go by instincts and say lower because
On instinct you say lower. The actual number of mothers who said they have told their daughter-in-law things they would not want their own son to know is 19. Yes! Sandy, very much lower. Don't tear up the set, Sandy. You've got control of the board, and you're looking at a two, a great base card.
Keep it, and I'm going to go higher.
Higher than a two. It is a seven. Now you're up the middle. What are you going to do?
I'm going to freeze.
You'll freeze. Needing one card to win, she freezes. Sandy, we asked 100 married women, does your husband talk in his sleep? How many women said yes?
I talk in my sleep. I think everybody talks in their sleep. I'm going to say 68.
68. Talk in their sleep, Sheila, higher or lower?
Boy, that's really tough. A lot might mumble, but I don't know how many actually talk.
Mumbling doesn't count, huh?
I'm going to say lower.
You say lower. The actual number of married women who said their husband talks in his sleep is... 34, Sheila. And your base card in the tiebreaker is a 4, also a fairly low card.
I'm going to play the 4 and go higher.
Higher than a 4? If this is lower than a king, you remain the champion. Sheila, congratulations. Sandy, thank you for joining us. Do say hello to our friends in Kentucky.
Oh, sure will.
Here's some nice parting gifts and $100. Thank you, Sandy. Sheila, come on down here. Get out the handkerchief. Sheila, you always start crying, but you're doing good, and she'll play the money cards in a moment, right after we take time out for this commercial message. Sheila Lyons, our champion, who has had some tough cards up there with the money cards.
Very tough cards.
But you've inched along up to $6,700.
That's not too shabby.
That's not too shabby, but there's over $28,000 up there if we can do it. Let's do it now. Let's open the board. Get to the money cards. Come on, Sheila. And again in the game, you won $200. Yours to keep. We never take that away from you. Now we've got a brand new deck of cards all shuffled and cut and new money to play with. This time you're going to bet that money. Starting on the bottom line, $200 and these three cards to bet. When you move to the second level, another $200 of betting money, three more cards. $50 minimum bets until you get to the top card, that big bet, and there you must bet at least half the money. Sheila, you haven't looked at too many face cards before. I want to see a lot of them now. King, deuce, ace, three, right?
Right.
Let's do it. $200. Come on, Sheila. Here's your first base card. You have a choice of two. It is an ace.
I take it. Okay. $200, it's lower.
Right away. The whole thing. $200 lower than an ace. It's a... That's the way we want it. $400 and a two.
$400, it's higher.
The whole thing again. $400 higher than a two. Oh, it's still a great card with $800.
I'm going $800, it's higher.
And again, the whole thing. $800 higher than a three. Oh, no. Oh, doggone it. Wow. However, you're still in it because that three moves up where we give you the other $200 of betting money.
I will bet.
Four cards to go. Come on.
I will bet the 200, it's higher.
All right. Build it again. $200 higher than a three. It is a king. $400 and a king.
$400, it's lower.
The whole thing again. $400 lower than a king. It's an eight. That's the first middle card. You're up to $800 with an eight, Sheila.
I'm going to go. I'm going to bet $200. Yeah. Cards are not good to me. $200 higher.
All right. $200 higher than an eight. No, it's a four. Doggone it. All right, that's a pretty good card, though, to move up for the big bet with $600. Sheila, you must bet at least $300. You have $600.
$600, it's higher.
The whole thing. All right, come on.
You'll
have nothing or $1,200. Higher than a four? No! You and these money cards, Sheila. That's terrible, and you started off so great to bust on them. But you're still here with $6,700.
Yes, I am.
Okay, come on down here with me. My goodness. I thought you had broken your jinx with the money card.
I thought I had too. I really did.
You couldn't have started any better.
I know it. I was so excited.
Well, we'll meet a new challenger right after we take time out for this commercial message. Maybe she'll get a chance to do it again. All right, Sheila, let's get ready to meet a new challenger. Janice will deal out two brand new decks of cards while we meet our next player on Card Sharks. Maxine Slater. Hi, Maxine. Nice to have you here.
Nice to be here. Thank you.
Tell us about yourself.
Well, my name is Angela Maxine Slater, but you can call me Maxine. I'm from England, but I'm visiting at the moment from Canada and enjoying the weather. And I'm a speech therapist.
Good. Nice to have you. Oh, you speak so very well. To
thank you so much.
Angela.
I just wanted to try Maxine for a while. You know, and a change now and again is good, you know.
Good. Nice to have you here with us. Maxine, you'll play the lower cards, the blue cards. Sheila, the upper cards, the red cards. Sheila, we asked 100 men. Now, given your choice, do you prefer a girl who's a little too skinny or a little too plump? How many men said they prefer a girl who's a little too skinny?
That's really tough. I know my husband would. He doesn't have much choice. And with heavier girls, I'm going to say more do, so I'm going to go with about 64.
She says 64 out of 100 prefer a woman who's a little too skinny, Maxine.
I think a lot of men do prefer plumper women, but I would say lower.
You say lower?
Yes, I'd say lower.
The actual number of men who prefer a girl who's a little too skinny is 54. It's lower. Maxine.
Great.
Pretty near the middle there. And Maxine, your base card is a big ace.
I've got to go lower.
Lower than an ace. It is an eight.
I think I'll freeze on that.
Freezing it right there. We'll move the freeze bar over. And the question goes to you, Maxine. We asked 100 women. Who do you find more attractive, a man who's a little too skinny or a little too plump? How many women said they prefer a man who's a little too skinny?
Well, I know what I prefer, and I prefer a little skinny. So I would say most women do, because the plump is beer belly very often, you know. So I would say about 55.
55, higher or lower, Sheila?
I agree with her, but I think it's going to be higher.
You say higher than that. The actual number of women who prefer a man who's a little too skinny is 51. It's not higher, Maxine. And very close in the answers, too. Maxine, you want to play this
change
or change
that,
it?
Please.
Here's the next card off the top of your deck. It's a three.
It has to be higher.
Higher than a three? It is a big king.
Lower.
Continuing lower than a king. A great card, a two.
Higher, please.
For the win, higher than a two. Yeah! Sheila, Maxine, and I'm Laverne. We'll all be back next time on Card Sharks. Bye-bye.
A representative of the studio audience will receive a library of Anthem books, including Imperial 109, a new novel that's gripping and exotic, books to read for fun furnished by Bantam. And some of our contestants will receive Billy the Kid fashion coordinates for boys of all ages, from toddlers to teens. Billy the Kid Boys Wear, available in all leading stores. And from Gallery of Homes, a book on home improvements. Gallery of Homes Brokers, if you're selling or buying a home, you'll find they do their homework. And long-lasting DuPont Lucite paint, custom blended in a rainbow of more than 1,000 colors for inside or outside your home. Top sealing Lucite goes on easy, looks great. And a supply of Yardley Old English Lavender Soap. Don't just lather up, lavender up with Yardley and give yourself a lavender lift. This is Gene Wood speaking for Card Sharks, a Mark Goodson, Bill Todman production.